everybody, Adam here with Beer Mushroom Gaming, and today I come to you with another unboxing. Today we will be unboxing a booster box of Eldritch Moon. So this was during the time in which I took a break from Magic. I understand that there's a Sweet Liliana in here, there's a Soren Markov in here. Beyond that, I know Emrakul makes an appearance over here. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and crack it open and see what we get. Bat knife. All right. Dispose of that. Oh, looks like there's a Tamiyo in here as well. That's pretty cool. Come here, Pax. Alright, dispose of that box. Because the box is not what we come for. Alright, so, while I get all this set up, I just want to inform everybody, and remind them that this is an unboxing, and like all of our unboxings, if there's anything you like and that you might want, make sure to leave a thumbs up and a comment down below, and I will see what I can do to get this card out to you. Now, the comment must consist of who you are, and what you would like. Alright, so just keep that in mind, and once the name is picked at random, I'll go ahead and take steps from there to reach out to you personally and find out where I need to send all this sweet swag. So, let's open up the Tamiyo pack first and see what we have going on. Oh wow, that real nice. I guess I don't know my own strength. Alright, so let's get past all these dumpster commons. Alright, the first card is Peace of Mind. Let me get this zoomed in for you. You would think I'd figure out how to get this done before I start recording, but I guess not. Peace of Mind. Mercurial Geist. Insatiable Gorgers. And our rare, Providence. For 5 colorless and 2 whites, a sorcery, you may reveal this card from your beginning hand. If you do at the beginning of your first upkeep, your life total becomes 26. Nice! And then when you cast it, your life total becomes 26. And then we have a flip card, or a transform card, Graft Rats. And on the back is the one half of Chittering Host. I don't know what that does. I'm sure we'll figure that out as we open packs. Looks like a zombie of sorts. And then we have an Eldrazi Horror and our transform placeholder. So we'll set that the Graph Rats aside as we move on to the next pack. Go away, commons. I hear there's a bunch of really good zombies in this deck. Or, I'm sorry, not zombies, but vampires. I'm sure there are good zombies, too. But, like I said, I know nothing. We have Prying Questions. Let's move our rares over here. Foul Emissary. He looks pretty cool. Lashweed Lurker. And our rare is Harmless Offering. Target opponent gains control of target permanent you control. Just giving up that kitten. Which I'm sure is, oh yeah, its tail is like a demon or a snake or something. I don't know if you can see that, but it bit the guy's thumb. Our transform card is Conduit of Storms. Transforms into Conduit of Emrakul. That's pretty cool. Set that over there. And then we have another Eldrazi Horror. So, so far our track record for opening Magic merchandise has been pretty good. We've in every box we've opened, we've gotten a Planeswalker, at least one. So that's really, it's a good sign for our luck. We got a Torrential Gearhulk with Kaladesh. I don't know if you guys remember that, but we're hoping to get some more sweet stuff out of this one. Graph Harvest, Vampire Cutthroat. Art looks amazing on that. Ride Down, and our rares, Collective Brutality. For a black and a colorless, Escalate, discard a card, and then choose one or more. Target opponent reveals his or her hand. You choose an instant or sorcery card from it, and that player discards that card. Or target creature gets -2/-2 till the end of turn. Or target player loses 2 life. You gain 2 life. It's a pretty solid card. I see this seeing a lot of play. Our transform card is a Grizzled Angler, which turns into Grizzly Angler Fish. Nice. And then we have a Human Soldier as our token. Hooray for Human Soldiers. Hooray for tokens. I can't be the only one in the world that likes tokens. Like, I almost look forward to seeing tokens more than anything else in the pack nowadays. I used to think rare lands were garbage, and then, well, I grew up. Rise from the Grave. Vexing Scuttler. Faith Unbroken, and our rare is Noosegraf Mob. For 4 and 2 black, Noosegraf Mob enters the battlefield with 5+1/+1 counters on it, and whenever a player casts a spell, remove a +1/+1 counter from this creature. If you do, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield. Pretty good. That's pretty good. And then our transform is a Cryptolith Fragment. It's an artifact. It adds mana to your mana pool, and each player loses 1 life. And it transforms into Aurora of Emrakul. A 1/4 flying death touch creature that, whenever it attacks, each opponent loses 3 life. That's really solid. I like the hell out of that card. Let's see, and then we have a Foist and a Spirit. Go. Next pack is Campaign of Vengeance. Repel the Abominable. Weaver of Lightning, and our rare, Crypt Breaker. For 1 black, it's a zombie creature. When you pay a colorless and a black, tap it, discard a card, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield, and when you tap 3 untapped zombies you control, you draw a card and you lose 1 life. Not bad. I dig it. Black needs more card advantage. And then Conduit of Storms is our flip card, which turns into Conduit of Emrakul. And then we have an Eldrazi Horror. So far, nothing bomby. Not yet. I have a feeling this pack's going to be pretty sweet, though. Alright. We have a Nephalia Academy. Savage Alliance. Courageous Outrider. And our rare is Oath of Liliana. For 2 colorless and a black, it's a legendary enchantment. When Oath of Liliana enters the battlefield, each opponent sacks a creature. At the beginning of each end step, if a planeswalker entered the battlefield under your control this turn, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token onto the battlefield. That's going to be sweet for Super Friends. Not a bad card. And then our transform is a Extricator of Sin. God, they need to fix these names. And it transforms into Extricator of Flesh. Not bad. Jesus, it gives all Eldrazi you control vigilance. And we have a Human Wizard token. That is pretty sweet looking. Alright, next pick. Alright, we have Long Road Home, Ruthless Disposal, Geist of the Archives, and our rare, Identity Thief. That's pretty cool. For 2 blue and 2 colorless, shapeshifter creature that whenever Identity Thief attacks, you may exile another target non-token creature. If you do, Identity Thief becomes a copy of it until the end of turn. Return the exiled creature to the battlefield under your opponent's control, or under its owner's control, sorry, at the beginning of the next end step. Pretty solid. Like, I'm going to copy your Emrakul and suck off, I guess. We got another Graph Rats with a Chittering Host on the backside. Oh, crap. And then we got another Transform card. Voldoran Pariah for 3 colorless and 2 black. You have a flying 3/3 vampire horror that you sacrifice 3 other creatures, transform Voldoran Pariah. With Madness of 3, her transform card is Abolisher of Bloodlines. An Eldrazi vampire flying, when this creature transformed into Abolisher of Bloodlines, target opponent sacks 3 creatures. It's a 6/5. That is pretty sweet. Holy crap. That is really sweet. Then we have an island and a human soldier. So this video is being recorded not long after New Year's. How was everyone's New Year's? Pretty good? Pretty boring? Mine was pretty uneventful, which is how I like them. I like to just sit around and spend time with my family. It's pretty awesome. If you have an interesting story from New Year's, go ahead and leave it in the comments below. Slayer's Cleaver, Graph Harvester, Incendiary Flow, and our rare is Assembled Alphas. For 5 colorless and a red, you get a wolf creature that whenever Assembled Alphas blocks or becomes blocked by a creature, it deals 3 damage to that creature and 3 damage to that creature's controller. That's not bad. I think the mana cost is a bit much. But, hey, what are you going to do? Alright, and then our transform is Vilden Pack Outcast, which turns into Drone Pack Kindred, an Eldrazi. Go figure. And then we have an insect as our token. Oh, so... yeah, just keep in mind, guys, if you want me to open anything in particular, like a particular set of Magic or maybe a particular game, leave it in the comments. Let me know. Until then, I'll just kind of like open whatever I feel might be entertaining for you guys. I know this is entertaining for me. Geist of Lonely Sigil, or sorry, Geist of Lonely Vigil, Hamlet Captain, Faith Unbroken, and our rare is Stitcher's Graft. For 1 colorless, it's an artifact equipment. Equipped creature gets +3/+3, and whenever equipped creature attacks, it doesn't untap during its controller's next untap step. Whenever Stitcher's Graft becomes unattached from a permanent, sack that permanent. Damn. Hot damn. Alright, and our transform card is Ulvenwald Captive, which turns into Ulvenwald Abomination. It just adds energy with an Eldrazi Horror token. Oh. Man, we're just kind of zooming through these packs today. Nothing really bomb yet, as far as I'm aware of. I mean, if I'm wrong and maybe one of these cards I already opened is amazing, let me know. Call me a dumbass. Do whatever you want to do. Haunted Dead, Dusk Feaster, Chilling Grasp, and our rare is Spell Queller. For a colorless, a blue, and a white, it's a flash flying spirit that when Spell Queller enters the battlefield, exile target spell with converted mana cost 4 or less. When it leaves the battlefield, the exiled card's owner may cast that card without paying its mana cost. That's pretty sweet. I dig that a lot. Transform card is an Extricator of Sin. Jeez. Having a hard time with that word today. Extricator. We have a spirit. A Oh, and if you're hearing a noise in the background, in the studio, it's balls-ass cold. And I have a space heater going so I can do these videos for you guys. And I don't die in the process. So, just letting you know that. We have Mockery of Nature, Incendiary Flow, Abundant Maw, and our fucking Planeswalker. We did it, guys. Liliana, the Last Hope. For colorless and two black, you get Liliana, comes in with three loyalty, plus one ability is up to one target creature, gets -2/-1 till your next turn. Words today. Her -2 ability is you put the top two cards of your library into your graveyard, then you may return a creature card from your graveyard to your hand. Pretty good. And her -7, her ultimate, is you get an emblem with, at the beginning of your end step, put X22 black zombie creature tokens onto the battlefield, where X is 2 plus the number of zombies you control. Nice. Very nice. Put her over here. And then our transform is Vilden Pack Outcast. Oh my god, we got another rare. Hanweir Battlements. It's a land. It's also a transforming land. This pack is sweet. You tap it to add an energy to your mana pool, and then you pay a red, tap it, target creature gains haste till the end of turn. Pay 3 colors and 2 red, tap it. If you both own and control Hanweir Battlements and a creature named Hanweir Garrison, exile them, then meld them into Hanweir the Writhing Township. Nice. Which apparently is a 7/4 creature, and this would be the top half of it. Pretty cool. It reminds me of, like, the Labyrinth. A bit. Oh, you're rare. You go over here. Now we have an island and a wolf. That was a pretty sweet pack. I enjoyed that pack. Alright, we are officially a third of the way through this box, and we've hit a Planeswalker, so that's a success. Our next card is Thirsting Axe. Subjugator Angel. That looks pretty sweet. Crop Sigil. And our rare, you already got sort of a sneak peek at it, is Spirit of the Hunt. Pay a colorless and two green, you get a wolf spirit with flash. And when Spirit of the Hunt enters the battlefield, each other creature you control that's a wolf or a werewolf gets +0/+3 until the end of turn. Pretty not bad. Pretty not bad at all. And then our transform is a Curious Homunculus, which turns into a Voracious Reader. Reading all the books. All of them. All them books. I didn't realize the Eldrazi were so bent on learning. An Eldrazi Horror as our token. Alright, on to the next stack of packs. First card is Campaign of Vengeance. Mourn Willow. Weaver of Lightning, and our rare, Collective Brutality. There's that rare we saw earlier today. Vilden Pack Outcast is our transform card. And then we got an insect token. Hooray for insect tokens! I wouldn't mind a Saurian as well. I mean, I like Planeswalkers. I like all Planeswalkers. They're all really cool. And I will take all of them. Alright, our next card is Repeal the Abominable. Abundant Maw. Mercurial Geist. And our rare is Ulvenwald Observer. For 4 colors and 2 green, you get a Tree Folk 6/6. Whenever a creature you control with toughness 4 or greater dies, you draw a card. That's pretty cool. I can dig it. Transform card is a Cryptolith Fragment. And then we have a foil, Waxing Moon. I mean, it's no Pokemon foil, but I'll take it. It looks nice. Looks real good. And then we have a Human Soldier and a Moontain. Alright, next pick. We have a Mockery of Nature. Insatiable Gorgers. Scour the Laboratory. That's a new card. And our rare is Bedlam Reveler. For 6 colorless and 2 red, you get a Devil Horror. That is a 3-4. Bedlam Reveler costs 1 colorless less to cast for each instant or sorcery card in your graveyard. It has Prowess. And when this creature enters the battlefield, discard your hand, then draw 3 cards. That's not bad if you have like a jank hand that you need to get rid of late game. And maybe you're looking for like that one bomb to just finish the game for you. Our transform is a Shrill Howler, which transforms into Howling Chorus. Kind of like a Cerberus. Pretty cool. Then we have an island and our first zombie token. Not bad. Alright, next pick. Geistfield Scarecrow. Crop Sigil. Drownyard Behemoth. And our mythic is Nahiri's Wrath. For 2 colorless and a red, it's a sorcery. It has an additional cost to cast Nahiri's Wrath. Discard X cards. Nahiri's Wrath deals damage equal to the total converted mana cost of the discarded cards to each of up to X target creatures and or planeswalkers. What? It should be worded, for each card you discard, deal combined mana cost to those damaging... No, I guess not. They explained it pretty well. I just suck at reading. Our transform card is Midnight Scavengers, which turns into the bottom half of something. Graph Rats. Cool. So I will show real quick what that turns into. Turns into a giant 5/6. Turns into a giant 5/6 with haste, menace, and when Chittering Host enters the battlefield, other creatures you control get +1/+0 and gain menace until the end of turn. Nice. Not bad. There. Well, at least we finished that one out. And then our foil is a Shrill Howler, which transforms into that Howling Chorus that we saw. And we got an Eldrazi Horror. Horror. Alright, next card. Geist of Lonely Vigil. Blood Mist. Clear Shot in our rare is a Wharf Infiltrator. For a blue and a colorless, it has Skulk. It's a human horror. And whenever Wharf Infiltrator deals combat damage to a player, you may draw a card. If you do, discard a card. Whenever you discard a creature card, you may pay 2 colorless. If you do, put a 3/2 colorless Eldrazi Horror creature token onto the battlefield. So many words. We have a Lone Rider as our transform card that turns into It That Rides as One. And then we have a Desperate Sentry as our foil, trying to fight off Eldrazi tentacles. And then we have Liliana's Emblem. I'll take it. Not bad. Now we have all the things to do what we wish with Liliana. Next card. Emrakul's Influence. Haunted Dead. Mournwillow, and our rare is Bloodhall Priest for a black, a red, and two colorless. Whenever Bloodhall Priest enters the battlefield or attacks, if you have no cards in hand, which means if you're hellbent for the older players, Bloodhall Priest deals 2 damage to target creature or player with a madness cost of a colorless, a black, and a red. Pretty good. Smoldering Werewolf is our transform card. He transforms into Erupting Dreadwolf. Pretty cool looking art. And then we got Spiders as our token. Oh, and then I drop everything everywhere. That's my luck, though. Alright. Alright, let's get back to the uncommons here. I already know what they are, but you don't. Lunar Force, Mockery of Nature, Lashweed Lurker, and our rare, Sanctifier of Souls, for 3 colors and a white. You get, whenever another creature enters the battlefield under your control, Sanctifier of Souls gets +1/+1 till the end of turn, so it's a token engine. When you pay 2 colors and a white, exile target creature, or exile a creature card from your graveyard, put a 1/1 white spirit creature token onto the battlefield. Pretty good. And then we have Alvinwald Captive, who transforms into Alvinwald Abomination. And then we got a wolf. Wolf creature token. All right. All right, uncommons in the next card, Thirsting Axe. Mockery of Nature. Noose Constrictor. And our rare, Stromkirk Occultist. For two colorless and a red, you get a Vampire Horror with Trample, and whenever it deals combat damage to a player, exile the top card of your library. Until the end of your turn, you may play that card with a madness of colorless and a red. That's a cool card. And then we have Kessig Prowler as our transform. It's a neat little one-coster. That turns into Sinuous Predator. And then we got an Eldrazi Horror. Horror. So yeah, we're just kind of moving right along in this box. Alright, next card is Fury Blade Vampire. Nebelgast Herald. Give No Ground, and our rare is Selfless Spirit. For a white and a colorless, you get a flying spirit creature that, when you sacrifice it, creatures you control gain indestructible until the end of turn. Pretty cool. It's a 2/1. And then our transform card is a Lone Rider, who turns into It That Rides as One. So it like melds with his horse. Cool. And then we have a different art zombie, which I dig. And if you want some of these tokens, feel free to, don't be afraid to ask. I mean, tokens aren't worth anything. So, they're just really cool to look at, in my opinion. The next pack, we have Savage Alliance. Vexing Scuttler. Murder. And our rare, Splendid Reclamation. For 3 colorless and a green, return all land cards from your graveyard to the battlefield tapped. Pretty friggin' sweet. Our transform card is Midnight Scavengers, who it transforms into. Oh man, I hope you guys just saw what was just pulled. It'll be the other half of that thing. We pulled a foil Splendid Reclamation out of the same pack we got a regular Splendid Reclamation. That personally has never happened to me. If it's happened to you in the past, sweet. put it in the comments, I guess. Tell me all about it. That is insane. And then our token is another art zombie token. I think I dig that art, the latest one, more than the other two. That was a weird pack. Let's do that with a Liliana. Or a Soren. That'd be okay, too. Alright. Next pack is Shreds of Sanity. Ride Down. Drugskull Shieldmate. And our rare is Permeating Mass for a green, a single green. You get a spirit that is a 1/3. Whenever it deals combat damage to a creature, creature becomes a copy of Permeating Mass. Pretty good. Pretty good. Huh. Lone Rider is our transform. It rides as one. And then our token. There's no token. None. No token. Don't you start this shit. Alright, next pack. I want my tokens back. We have Lunar Force. Advanced Stitchwing, Gnarlwood Dryad, and our rare is Dark Salvation. This is pretty interesting. For XX and black, target player puts X22 black zombie creature tokens onto the battlefield, then up to one target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn for each zombie that player controls. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Our transforming card is a Smoldering Werewolf, which turns into Erupting Dread Wolf. Then we got a Plains and another zombie token. Alright, so we are 2/3 of the way through this box. Let's just keep it moving. What do you say? Alright, next card is Prying Questions. Geist of the Archives, Markov Crusader, that looks pretty cool. Our rare is Niblis of Frost, 2 colorless, 2 blue, flying 3/3 with prowess. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, tap target creature and opponent controls. That creature does not untap during its controller's next untap step. Pretty cool. I see a lot of use coming out of that. And then Midnight Scavengers, which transforms into the thingamabob. Forest. And a spirit. I don't understand why I'm having such a hard time remembering what the combo transform card is. I guess just it must not be that cool to me. I mean, the mechanic has been around in Yu-Gi-Oh! Forever. Not quite to that extent, like where you take two cards and you literally put them together. Emrakul's Influence, Deranged Whelp, Somberwald Stag, and our rare is Coax from the Blind Eternities. For 2 colorless and a blue, it's a sorcery. You may choose an Eldrazi card you own from outside the game or in exile, reveal that card, and put it into your hand. That's pretty busted. Graphrats is our transform. It turns into that Chittering Host. And then our foil is Clear Shot. And then we got a Devil Token. Yay! Something new. Alright. Let's try and get through these here. Next card is Thirsting Axe, Gnarled Dryad. Ride down, and our rare is Stormkirk Condemned. For 2 black, it's a vampire horror. Discard a card. Vampires you control get +1/+1 till the end of turn. Activates ability only once each turn. Not bad. Transform is Graphrats. And then we got an insect token. Alright, next pack. Just zooming along now. Shreds of Sanity, Fortune's Favor, Subjugator Angel, and our rare, I'm sorry, our mythic, Mirror Wing Dragon. For 3 colorless and 2 red, it's a flying 4/5. Whenever a player casts an instant or sorcery spell, it targets only Mirror Wing Dragon. That player copies that spell for each other creature he or she controls. Then, that the spell could target. Each copy targets a different one of those creatures. Holy shit. Giant Growth. Go. That thing is busted. Vilden Pack Outcast is our transform. Oh shit. And then we got another mythic. Gisela, the Broken Blade. For 2 colorless and 2 white. It's a legendary creature. Angel Horror. Flying First Strike Lifelink. At the beginning of your end step, if you both own and control Giselle the Broken Blade and a creature named Bruna the Fading Light, exile them, then meld them into Brisella, Voice of Nightmares. We flip it over. That's pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. Becomes a 9/10, I believe, is the end result there. And then we got a zombie token. Yay, tokens! So, here's to hoping we get a Bruna. It's like they do the fusion dance from Dragon Ball Z. It's pretty awesome. Next pack, Prying Questions. Unsubstantiate. Weaver of Lightning. And our mythic is a Decimator of Provinces. It's a 10 cost Eldrazi Boar. Well, that is a 7/7 with Emerge, 6 colors, 3 green. And when you cast Decimator of Provinces, creatures you control get +2/+2 and gain Trample until the end of turn. It's a Trampling Haster. And then we got Midnight Scavengers with a foil Abundant Maw. We'll take it. Then we got Devil Token. Yay, Devil Token! So now we're starting to hit, like, the sweet stuff. Let's see, we got like 5 or 6 mythics now. We got Planeswalker. I mean, that's really all I wanted, but I'll take whatever's left. We have a Blessed Alliance, Abandoned Reason, Markov Crusader, and our rare is Heron's Grace Champion. For 2 colorless, a green and a white, it has Flash and Lifelink. When Heron's Grace Champion enters the battlefield, other humans you control get +1/+1 and gave Lifelink until the end of turn. Pretty sweet. And then we have Curious Homunculus, which turns into Voracious Reader. And then we have an Eldrazi Horror and a Swamp. So, guys, we've got, let's see, 6 packs left. Let's see. This next pack has a Peace of Mind, Abandoned Reason, Liliana's Elite. Oh my god, we got a Tamiyo! Field Researcher. For a colorless, a green, a white, and a blue, her +1 ability is choose up to 2 target creatures until your next turn. Whenever either of those creatures deals combat damage, you draw a card. Not bad. Her -2 ability is tap up to 2 target non-land permanents they don't untap during their controller's next untap step. Her -7 is draw 3 cards. You get an emblem with... You may cast non-land cards from your hand without paying their mana cost. Holy shit. Oh my god. So good. We have a Midnight Scavengers, a Foil Plains, and then we got a Zombie Token. Dude, this box is good. I didn't think we were gonna get multiple planeswalkers. I figured we were just gonna get one, like we normally do. But I'll take it. Alright, Blood Mist. Rise from the Grave. Liliana's Elite. And our rare is Imprisoned in the Moon. For a two colorless and a blue, it's an enchantment. Enchant target creature, land, or planeswalker. Enchanted permanent is colorless land. When you tap it, you add an energy to your... a colorless, like an actual colorless, to your mana pool. And loses all other card types and abilities. Dude, that's going to piss all like the Super Friends players off. Our transform is Tangleclaw Werewolf, which turns into Fibrous Entangler. Also a really cool card. Damn it. Damn it all to hell. Give me my tokens. You all come to see the tokens. I know it to be true. Next pack here. Unsubstantiate. Spreading Flames, Scour the Library, and our rare is Eternal Scourge. For three colorless, it's an Eldrazi Horror. You may cast Eternal Scourge from exile. That's a really cool mechanic. When Eternal Scourge becomes the target of a spell or ability an opponent controls, exile Eternal Scourge. So it protects itself. That's good. Our transform is a Vilden Pack Outcast into a Drone Pack Kindred. And then our rare transform card is a Hanwir Garrison. For two colorless and a red, you get a human soldier. Whenever Hanwir Garrison attacks, put two 1/1 red human creatures creature tokens onto the battlefield tapped and attacking, and then it melds with Hanwir Battlements. So that's pretty awesome, actually. I dig it. And then we have a red human token. Alright guys, we have three packs left. Come on! Open up! All the packs up until now have been super easy to open, except for that one. Alright, we have Nephalia Academy, Clear Shot, Courageous Outrider, and our mythic is Deploy the Gatewatch. For four colorless and two white, look at the top seven cards of your library. Put up to two planeswalker cards from among them onto the battlefield. Put the rest on the bottom of your library in random order. Busted. That is a busted card. Alvinwald Captive turns into Alvinwald Abomination. And then we have a spirit token. Two more packs left, guys. Alright, second to last pack is gonna contain Blessed Alliance, Drownyard Behemoth, Vampire Cutthroat, and our rare Soul Separator. For three colorless, you can pay five colorless, tap it, sack Soul Separator, exile target creature card from your graveyard, put a token onto the battlefield that's a copy of that card, except it's a 1/1, and it's a spirit in addition to its other types, and it has flying. Put a black zombie creature token onto the battlefield with power equal to that card's power and toughness equal to that card's toughness. Cool. It's a lot of words for just make a copy of something and get a spirit. Alvinwald Captive is our transform, and then Ingenious Scob is our foil. And then a red human. Last pack, guys. This is going to be the pack. This is going to be the one with a regular Sorin and a foil Sorin in the same pack. Who's ready? Alright. Abandoned Reason, Dusk Feaster, Crop Sigil, and our rare. Oh, it's a Bedlam Reveler. Okay. And then a Grizzled Angler is our transform with a zombie as our token. Alright, guys. Well, thanks for checking out this video. As always, just if you find something that you like, make sure to leave a comment down below. If you haven't already, subscribe. That's you guys are the reason we do this. And make sure to leave some feedback, all right? Until next time, this is Adam from Bearded Mushroom Gaming, and I thank you guys for checking out this video. I'll see you next time. Bye.